Don't need to kill the captain, do it. We can do this though.
What seems to be the trouble, Hiroshio? Tell me why you're so concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The time is upon you. I am here. Say your piece.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
You are my master's sworn enemy.
Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
I feel an overwhelming need for bloodshed.
Hiroshio, defend yourself. The Sith attacks. Excessive display. Those men were defenseless and unarmed.
There wasn't, he had a gun.
That was the difference in the fight.
You are every bit your master's minion. I shall honor Hiroshio and his men's lives by dedicating myself to thwarting you and your master.
I'm sure they feel better about dying now.
Make all the snide comments you like, Sith. There is much you don't know. It calms me that you and Barriss have no idea what you're up against.
Your pupil's powers are a sham. She is leading you on a witch hunt.
Ah, you know more than I thought. Barriss, no doubt, is after my Padawan. How unfortunate. I've kept her identity and location a secret. So you and your master are just feeling your way in the dark. But my Padawan is of supreme importance to me in the Jedi Order. I will not let harm come to her.
I would expect nothing less.
In that case, I shall exceed your expectations, my friend. You're about to find out how resourceful I can be. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
I already met the Republic's finest.
You're digging your own grave.
And you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in, by any means necessary. Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
No one else has to die. We can discuss this peacefully, Master Carr.
If only that were true. My place is by my Padawan's side, teaching her the ways of the Force and honing her talents. I will do everything in my power to keep her hidden from you.
Wear yourself out.
Until we meet again.
Okay. Let's do something extremely lazy. Going to travel to it from here. Don't think we'll level up after this.
Apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
I will obliterate everything she knows.
I am confident this is how we will prevail. The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish you cause will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
Or?
Perhaps the Padawan can be turned.
Her power would be a great asset, yes. Put through enough torment, she may reveal her base nature. But we must be cautious. The danger she represents is extreme. As long as she lives, she is a threat. Seduction to the dark side should be left to masters. If there is even a sliver of doubt in your heart, it can backfire.
I will be mindful, Master.
You have yet to face a Jedi Master. Their righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating. And Noman Carr is no ordinary master. Confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
I will not falter. My hate knows no bounds.
Just be sure it serves you. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her.
Okay, two new locations. Let's make a push. See how far we can get. Let's begin with Tatooine. I remember that I liked Alderaan. It was beautiful there.
Sands of Tatooine await you, Apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Noman Carr brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
I will bring the old man to his knees.
Noman Carr shelters his prize, so we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves. My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste. But give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
Right, off we go.
The harsh sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharok Reeve. Our lord and master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yonlok.
Just tell me where to find the Jedi.
It is not such a simple matter.
What's this?
You will find Master Yanlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
Now you've got my undivided attention.
The sand demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch. I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing? Its skin was glistening.
Somehow, she avoided fighting the demon.
That appears to be the only conclusion. What happened in that cave is a mystery. As is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabeau Jeef. He's as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
I want to talk with this man immediately.
It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
They won't see me coming until it's too late.
Then I will meet you at Isabeau Jeef's hut.
That's a spirit. Okay. Let's do it. I haven't done any heroics yet. I can't port around like I have. That's going to cost a little bit of time, but I don't think it will be that far. Just going to ride as hard as I can here.
Good to go.
The world is weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabeau.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
That's right.
You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
Failure can be contagious. And hard to dispel once contracted. You are the seeker Sharak spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
I'm used to getting what I want.
The spoiled child often becomes lazy.
Please, Isabeau, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify. The sands speak of a ritual called the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharak witnessed was engaged in.
I don't appreciate dramatic pauses.
Breath does not come as easily for the aged, Dark One. The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh sand demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the Demon Slayer, the Savage Ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the Slayer seeks.
According to Sharak, the Padawan did not slay the beast.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood, but you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the Savage Ones speak.
I appreciate your help and insights.
Step lightly on my desert. It has been through so much in its life.
Here are the coordinates you will need. After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes.
If you say so. Lucy leveling up. We're gonna have to be smarter. If I now try to fast travel anywhere, it will tell me I can only go here. But I have a speeder nearby. So what if I go everywhere now? Unlock it. And then save a lot of time in the long run, hopefully. Sand People compound. So we should start there.
At your service, my lord.
Okay, let's just go here. Missions completed, story time.
You're good to go.
Should be somewhere in front of me. There it is. That has to be the place. items here. Got a few kills and I will level up. Yeah, that's a level. That, okay, we need that one. Beautiful.
Can we talk for a second? I really don't have a good feeling about this.
Have you flirted with her?
I'll make you feel better later.
We're about to face a monster that can swallow us whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the demon blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, could we please get through this without mixing it up with the sand demon?
Maybe.
We'll see, Vet. I'll try.
That's all I ask. Thank you. Looks like it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up if it goes badly.
Well, I will just kill it. It's time for a heroic moment. It's pissed. Big time.
Forget subtlety. The beast must die!
That is such a... That is so funny.
Oh, yuck! So much blood! If I knew we were gonna literally bathe in it, I would have waited outside. And the smell... Oh, Kag! We're gonna stink for days! What if it never wears off?
We'll be all right, Vet.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So, let's get out of the stink pit, huh?
Well, Vet, we don't even have a shower on the ship.
You took the words out of my mouth.
Lead the way.
Where do we need to go? In there, it's just outside. Okay, we cannot use that, so we're gonna have to run out. I hope we can make it to 65, use the new gear and everything. That would be so good for starting tomorrow.
All better.
Thank you. They're running away.
All better.
I think you should go.
I trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The Sand People all ran from you. What transpired inside the Sand Demon Cave that makes this so?
It was an epic battle, and I killed the beast.
You have bathed in the demon's blood. Its essence fills the air. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. There doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! On your guard, Offworlder. One of the Sand People approaches.
And he's wounded. Overseen grunts, he bows before you and holds out a weathered parchment.
Enough of this.
There's nothing to stop you.
Didn't even attempt to defend itself. I've never seen one of its kind be so passive.
Well, it was the last one, the only one, and I killed it.
This parchment the Sand Person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine and there is no such door.
Tell me anything else important about the area.
I can tell you that humans are very low on the food chain there.
Yeah, okay,
we
don't...
The ravine marks the farthest I or anyone I know of has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed, using the dune's shadows.
Then I'll see you there.
You won't see me until I wish to be seen. Head deeper into the desert, and you will find the Desert Wound Ravine. Safe journey.
Ah, 16 minutes. Oasis. Doesn't look like I can fast travel anywhere. Actually, I can save some time here. We're going there. And I wonder if I can get closer by using a speeder.
All authorized destinations.
Don't think so. It's so hard to see. The risk is that I might miss it completely. So let's just run. That's the safest bet we have. Oh no, we could have taken a speeder. Why didn't it tell us? Could have saved some time there. Oh well. It is what it is.
Thank you.
Nobody better mess with us now. This is either a mirage or a trap set by an...
Oh, something is happening.
You have lost your way, Dark One, but I have come to correct your course. I am the embodiment of your greatest potential. I am what you could be if you overcame your fear and walked in the light.
Oh.
You're mistaken. I am walking the light path. It is fruitless to lie to me. I am you. I know your heart. If you persist down this path, your life will be consumed by paranoia and fear. Betrayal will wait around every corner. You will never know whom to trust. I don't live in a fantasy world. Trust is an illusion. To someone who only knows darkness, it would seem so. You see, the dark side seeks to subjugate the Force. It treats the Force as an adversary to be used and manipulated. When you embrace the light, you meld with the Force, become part of it. Then true clarity and peace can be achieved. I can see why that would have its advantages. It is the true purpose of the Force. Look at our master. If the dark is so potent, why is Darth Barriss deathly afraid of a young girl? Nomen Kaar's Padawan is merely a nascent champion of the light, and already she strikes fear into the heart of a dark side master. That is a powerful argument. Maybe the light is stronger. Then choose now to reverse your path. Commune with me, turn away from the darkness, and walk among the enlightened.
Well, we can choose.
I deny the dark side and endeavor to embrace goodness. You are wise. We embrace now, and you take your first step toward truth and purity. Yes, you have opened yourself to your true destiny. Now we are one. In the clarity of this communion, a vision of our destiny on Tatooine appears. Can you see it too? An encampment hidden in the farthest reaches of the desert, past a rock formation called the Forbidden Pass. Is this where I will find the Jedi Master Yornlok? There is no doubt this is where the Padawan went. This is where the Great Master helped her powers become expressed. The image fades. Find the Forbidden Pass and confront Master Yornlok beyond it. Our journey on this planet ends there. Farewell.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed. Did you just tell yourself to venture beyond the Forbidden Pass?
Did I?
That is my understanding.
I am chilled to the bone. The desert beyond the Forbidden Pass is an area that no one can survive. No one! Even the Sand People dare not go. You mustn't go!
Your concern for me is unnecessary.
This is not some silly superstition. Those who go beyond the Forbidden Pass are never seen again. I will not. I cannot follow you there.
You've done enough, Shorik. Thank you.
That is kind of you to say. I told Lord Barriss I would see your mission through, but I never imagined it would come to this. With a heavy heart, I give you the location of the Forbidden Pass.
Just like that.
I am shamed that my cowardice paralyzes me. I fear I will never see you again.
I hope your fear comes comes true.
Suddenly, you're afraid of everything.
It seems so. My spirit is broken. I will return to your spaceport and inform Darth Barriss of this development. I bid you goodbye.
When we get a chance, let's talk.
It would seem that we need to ride over there. I can't mount in here. I think I've cornered myself. Tells us to use the space, the speeder now, that's good. But if I knew that, I would have teleported over here straight away. I saved some time.
Displaying all authorized destinations.